What's happening, guys? It's Smash here. I wanted to make a quick video because I'm actually super excited that this finally happened. RNG is starting to work on my behalf, so I wanted to pass this information along to you guys and more or less just kind of get some of your thoughts. Let me backtrack a little bit so you guys can kind of understand why I'm making this video. The last couple of weeks, I've jumped into Destiny almost full-time, right? I've been making a lot of videos, or I've been making some videos for this channel. I've been streaming it pretty much every day. I've been jumping into the game pretty much head-on. And I've really just been primarily focusing on just doing PvP. Thing that has been a problem for me is, besides the fact that I'm trash, haven't been able to quite figure out what kind of role I wanted to go with, and kind of observing what the meta has been, since I'm actually more or less a new player here. So I'm just speaking from a noob's perspective, and I would appreciate anyone to drop any insight. So where I'm getting at with this is, I've been trying to figure out what loadout I want to go with, and it seems like in order for me to be competitive, whether it be in Crucible, comp, trials, whatever, I need to have a meta build and something that kind of works. Run hand cannon sniper, or hand cannon shotgun, or AR shotgun, not going towards a double primary. For a while, I've been running a double primary. I've been running Vigilance Wing, Gnawing Hunger. Everyone's been running Gnawing Hunger, I know that. And I've been loving using that gun, but I've been trying to figure out, there has to be a way for me to be competitive and still not be at a disadvantage in some way. Because I've been running into a lot of situations where I'm getting into gun battles and I am at a complete range disadvantage. With that being said, I finally unlocked the Iclos Sniper. I actually saved up about 10 umbrals, and every single umbral was the damn sniper. My RNG has been fantastic. The one that I decided to go with is actually this role here, because all the other roles I'm gonna go over in just a second. This one in particular seems to be the best option. We got ourselves quick draw, fourth time's a charm. We're gonna talk a little bit about quick draw here, because this seems to be the most common suggested perk, if you will, that I should be running on this. I know a lot of people like the snapshot sights, which I completely understand. And I will tell you right now, just to kind of spoil the rest of this video, I did not get that role on any of those. For now, for me being a new player, quick draw seems to be the better perk to go with, so that I can kind of understand what the gun is capable of. Got a stability masterwork, which I've also been told is actually really, really good. And I ended up throwing on a targeting adjuster just to kind of help me with my aim assist, since my aim is booty. Now I want to go back here a little bit and kind of show you guys some of the other roles and seeing what you might actually get. A lot of these roles that I ended up getting on the focused umbrals were triple tap and multi-kill clip. I've used multi-kill clip on Gnawing Hunger, which seems to work really, really well. I feel like for anyone like me who still has a very high skill gap to try to climb up, multi-kill clip is probably not the best, just because I'm not going to be getting multiple kills. Let's just be honest. I'm going to be missing my shots. I'm probably going to be hitting below the waist, or I'm going to be hitting at the chest. I'm not going to be hitting precision shots. So getting multi-kill clip is really not going to be that beneficial to me. Whereas with the role that I have now with quick draw and four times a charm, that's going to give me a better opportunity to get the kill and get the gun out faster. That's why we're going to be sticking with this role. As you can see, yeah, triple tap and quick draw. This was actually the second role that I got, and I was kind of contemplating back and forth and going with triple tap. Let me dive into this really quick. So triple tap, rapidly landing precision hits will return one round to the magazine. The only difference between four times a charm and triple tap is one extra round in the mag. And this one also has a stability masterwork, so they're pretty much the same. Is it really that much of a big difference? Probably not. I'm probably overthinking it, as I do everything in life. But going back to this, it seems like fourth times a charm is the better roll, just for that extra round. That's fine. Feeding frenzy and box breathing. I believe this one also had a yes. So this one has box breathing and multi-kill clip again. So you can kind of see the trend here is that we're continuously getting multi-kill clip. I put box breathing on this one, kind of looking at it. I'm thinking, okay, maybe if I'm aiming down for that short period, I might get that extra range. But I don't trust myself to hit that precision shot. So I don't know if I'm going to be able to really benefit from this perk. Also had a handling masterwork on it. So might hold on to this one too. Going down to the last two, we got moving target, high impact reserves. Again, no distractions, high impact reserves. So we got a lot of not very mixed bag. They're very trendy, it seems like. I'm getting four with the same roll, three with the same roll. They're very much the same. Not really sure if this is any good, because I'm going to be completely honest. I feel like no distractions is really good just for that short period to reduce the flinch. So if I'm getting shot, I'm obviously not going to have to worry about taking that flinch, and I can still make my shot. So that's really, really good. I feel like using a perk like no distractions will probably be better if I can actually hit my fucking shots. I'm not trusting myself to hit these shots right now. I still have a lot of practice to do with this gun. So might keep this and kind of play around with them and see what's going to be better. Again, there's that multi-kill clip that I've continued to get on pretty much every single roll on this sniper. And I decided to go with high impact reserves just because, hey, we want to get that extra damage to help me get that kill. Also, I noticed that all of these snipers don't have a range masterwork. They're all handling and stability, but we got a lot of these, and it seems like this is going to be one of the snipers going into the next season that will be the meta. So I've got a lot to choose from here, but I want you guys to let me know what perks I should be focusing on, not just as a new player, but as a player who is trying to progress and get better. Which roles should I be going for the most? So far, it seems like this is the role that I should be sticking with for the foreseeable future. I still want to try out the other ones and see if they're worthwhile. But at first, I think I need to kind of focus on getting better with the gun first before I can start focusing on the roles. Having these roles in to my benefit, this is only going to help me. So I'm happy with this. I'm gonna stick with this for a little while. But I want you guys to tell me, which one do you think is going to be better moving forward into the next season? Leave me a comment down below. Hit the like button if this video helped you a little bit. If it didn't, I am sorry. Go ahead and hit that thumbs down. And if you want any more of this type of Destiny content, you should totally hit that subscribe button. Make sure you watch the live stream on Twitch over twitch.tv/smash. Check the description below. Appreciate you guys watching, and I'll catch you guys in the next video.